Hi, and welcome to School Month. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today is Thursday, March 30th. It's the second to last day of Scope Month, but that means we're going to be giving away five more 1000X series oscilloscopes. For today's scope tip, we're actually going to talk a little bit about probes. One of the new things that came out with the 1000X series scopes is these probes. They're switchable 10-to-1, 1-to-1 attenuation. And that begs the question, when would you use a 10-to-1 probe? When would you use a 1-to-1 probe? Or when would you use something like a 100-to-1 probe? Well, you generally want to use the higher attenuation ratios for higher voltages. It comes down to the way that the attenuation in the probe works. If I'm in 10-to-1 mode and I probe a 1-volt signal, it's only going to pass 100 millivolts into the scope, and the scope is going to recognize the probe as a 10-to-1 and show you 1 volt on the screen. So higher attenuations are useful if you're trying to take a really big voltage and scale it down so that you're not going to blow out the inputs of your scope. 1-to-1 attenuation is useful for making lower noise measurements, especially on lower voltage signals. And we can actually see this phenomena on the scope. I've pulled out my 1000X, and right now I'm in 1-to-1 mode, and I'm probing the probe comp port of the scope. And when I switch to 10-to-1 attenuation, you'll see that the signal drops by 10X, and I can switch back and forth and see that's consistently changing over time. Also notice that this bar, the thickness of that is generally the noise floor of the scope. And as I switch between 10-to-1 and 1-to-1, the thickness of the signal there at 0 and 1 is not changing between the two attenuations. So if I wanted to get a more accurate measurement of my probe comp symbol, I'd want to be in 1-to-1 mode. And now let's draw today's five 1000X series oscilloscope winners. Our winners are Elizabeth Laffey, Carson Hoffman, Philip Wallner, Dennis Wachter, and Lasa Tilakaratne. Congratulations to our winners. We'll be in touch with you shortly. Let's take a quick look at another Test to Impress entry. Remember, you have until March 31st at 11 p.m. UTC to get your entries in.
We are the BRS Motorsport Team, a non-profit association of students from St. Augustine in Germany, which works completely independently from our universities. Every year we build a new fully electric race car to participate in the Formula Student Competition all over Europe to compete with different Formula Student teams from all over the world. Over 70 team members from different fields of studies work on this interdisciplinary project. We use 7 control units in our car, which we design and develop on our own. Our main focus is to build a safe car, because on the events in the summer, a fellow student will drive the prototype. So, due to good engineering praxis, we have to test all functions beforehand. Especially critical signal lines are very important to test for us, because unstable signals can be corrupted by EMC due to the electrical powertrain of the car. Furthermore, we have no possibility of data connection to a computer with our oscilloscopes. This makes it very hard to create a professional documentation of our projects.
And that's the reason why we need your support. We want an oscilloscope with more features because we want to improve and learn more about our designs. Only this way, our skills can be better and we can gain a better understanding for circuit technology.
That's all for today. Make sure you tune in tomorrow at 10 a.m. Mountain Standard Time for our live stream Scope Month finale. Subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. I'll see you tomorrow. Today is Monday, March. Monday, March. It's not Monday. Today is Thursday. It's Thursday? Thursday. I'm going to talk a little bit in my recording. Okay. Yes. One of the new things that came out with the 1000X, this is not a 1000X.